The U.S., meanwhile, is confident Ukraine can win the war against Russia if they have the right equipment. Speaking to reporters after his trip to Kyiv, Pentagon Chief Lloyd Austin claimed Moscow has lost a lot of military capability.
In terms of their ability to win, the first step in winning is believing that you can win. And so they believe that we can win. We believe that they can win if they have the right equipment, the right support. And we're going to do everything we can, continue to do everything we can to ensure that that gets.
Russia's bombardment of Ukraine continues. At least five are reported killed, while over a dozen are wounded after rockets hit Ukraine's central Vinnytsia region. Earlier, Russia's defense ministry also said their missiles destroyed six facilities powering railways that deliver foreign weapons to Ukraine in the eastern Donbas region. The attacks come as the U.S. unveils new military assistance for Ukraine following the visit of U.S. Secretary of State Antony Blinken and Defense Secretary Lloyd Austin to the country. Russia has warned the U.S. and its Western allies to stop sending more arms to Ukraine. Well, the United States could see its first envoy to Ukraine in about 3 years as it ramps up aid to the war-torn country. According to the White House, President Joe Biden has nominated career diplomat Bridget Brink to the post. Bridget is the current U.S. ambassador to the Slovak Republic. She also served as the U.S. State Department handling European affairs. The U.S. has not had an envoy to Ukraine since 2019 when former President Trump recalled Marie Yovanovitch. Ivanovich was accused of undermining Trump's efforts to dig up dirt on Biden and his son Hunter, who had business dealings in Ukraine.
Over in the U.S., former President Donald Trump held in contempt for failing to turn over documents in connection with the probe on his business practices. The New York judge also ordered Trump to pay $10,000 per day until he complies. Trump's lawyer says they will appeal the ruling. New York Attorney General Letitia James had opened a civil inquiry into Trump's business practices in 2019 amid allegations the tycoon had manipulated his financial statements to further his business interests. James on Twitter hailed the judge's decision, saying, "Today, justice prevailed."